Hi, my name is Jamie Thurman, and I am Joey Thurman's wife. He's no Joe. And in the show, I do an aerial act called the Swinging Ladder. I also do fire poi, fire fans, juggling cube, breathe fire. And behind the scenes, I do the sound, the music, the lights, smoke machine, all that stuff too. I grew up in a small town in Dallas, Georgia, which is in Paulding County, and it's about, 45 minutes away from Atlanta. And Joe's actually from that town too. But we didn't meet each other until later when we were adults. And I was 19 when I met him, and it was a week before my birthday in January. And we got engaged that February and married that August. And so it was very quick, and we've been together for 12 years. We actually just celebrated our 12 year anniversary a couple days ago. But it wasn't, I didn't have a normal childhood. And so now that I'm an adult, I'm really kind of having fun being out with the circus and traveling and going to different towns, and it's really, I've had a really great adulthood, and that's been really, really nice. Everyone who comes to our show, they see us come out into the show. It's already set up, it's pretty, the lights, the fog, the music and everything, and we're all in our costumes and the glitter and everything, and they think we just kind of magically appear there. And what people don't realize and what they don't see is how hard it is to set all that up, to make it look so good. You know, we pull into a town and we've got a day, sometimes even just a night, to set the show up, and it's just us. This year it's just me, Joe, Hernan, and Kayla, and the four of us to set up that show by ourselves will take like 6 hours. And all of us work. You know, me and Kayla work just as hard as the men do. I drive sledgehammers, she picks up heavy things. I mean, it takes all four of us to really, really work hard. And the next day, you know, our back hurts or we're tired, and we have to go out there and smile and look pretty and make everything look like it's easy. But it's it can be tough. I mean, it's show and business, and half of that's show, half of that's business. And half of the show that the people see is so much more. I mean, our show is two 30-minute shows, but what it takes to make a 30-minute show is, you know, like I said, a 6 hour long setup time. And then to book and to go to conventions in January and to go to every state that we play to, and, you know, hope that we get booked. And then once we get booked, come home and spend hours and hours and days in the office calling everyone and emails and faxes, and it's a lot. It's a lot of work. I mean, it is a good payoff, and I'm happy. I would never want to have another 9-to-5 job as long as I live. This is nice, but it is tough. Anybody who owns their own business, there's a lot of, you know, where the money is going and taxes and insurance and, you know, doing dangerous stuff. It's very hard, but in the end, it is worth it. When Hernan came and he built the ladder apparatus, he taught me most of the positions of what to do because his mother used to do that act, and he's from circus. His parents and grandparents and so on and so on, they've done it for like 100 years or so. And and me and Joe are not, we don't have a circus background, we're first generation. And so I've had to watch other people, watch videos, and then just kind of get on it and feel it. You know, it's not just me controlling it. I have to work with the ladder and when it's moving and know, you know, how to center it and how to swing when I want. And it took a lot of practice, a lot of practice. And the fire, the poi, I did poi with ribbons for about 4 years until I felt like I was good enough to do it with fire. That's the hardest thing I do. That's harder than the ladder. There's no room for error or no, when I'm on the ladder, I can feel, okay, well, I want to drop, or no, I'm going to take a second and drop, or, you know, I'm going to wait till the next fall back and do, you know, I have time. When I do the poi, there is no time. It has to be perfect every single time, or it'll tangle up, it'll hit you in the face, it'll hit you somewhere, and it's on fire. I don't want to catch myself on fire, especially my hair. That's the whole time I'm doing it, all I can think about is don't set your hair on fire, don't set your hair on fire. And the juggling cube is the same way. It's very large. You have to learn where to put your hands, how to get it started, and we try to smile there and everything and make it look easy. But it's really, it's because I've been doing it for 4 or 5 years to where if it looks easy and I'm smiling, trust me, when I come down and I go back behind the tent, I'm drinking water and panting and trying to catch my breath. and that's all of us. We all try to make it look easy, but it's very tough what we do. But a lot of it was self-taught, watching DVDs and just playing with it, just picking up the things and playing with it and seeing what looks good and what doesn't look good. Anytime one of us comes up with a new act, whether it's the clown or the acrobat or whoever, we have each other. if I say, okay guys, I'm gonna do this, what do you think? I have Joe and Hernan and Kayla to say, oh, that looks good, or that doesn't look good. And that's where I get most of my constructive criticism from. Performing is a lot of fun. It is hard work, and once you get over that learning how to do it, and now I know how to do it, it is fun. I can take the time to have fun. Whenever I put my foot in the loop and I wait for the ladder to swing back and I fall, and it takes my stomach every time, and it's so much fun. It's almost like flying, and it feels so nice, and it's always a great release for anything. It's almost like meditation to me. And I think the best part of performing is having the kids look at you with awe in their eyes and like an inspiration. And especially afterward when they say, oh, I want to grow up and do this or do that. And I tell them, you can grow up and be anything you want. It's a lot of work and a lot of practice, but if you do it, then you can do it. And it's just so rewarding to have, to just see their faces and to see people smile. And if you can bring those people out of their reality and out of their world of work and stress and whatever they have going on, and just for 30 minutes make them forget about everything and have a good time, that the applause and the smiles on the faces, it's the best reward that any of us can get. We miss our parents and everything. It is hard to be on the road, but at the same time, the people who are at home waiting on us, I know it seems like a long time for them. But when we're on the road, it doesn't seem like so long because we're constantly in a new town every week. And it's fun because, like, right now we're in Indiana, Pennsylvania, which is about an hour from Pittsburgh. And it's so beautiful up here. It's September 1st, and the leaves on the trees are starting to fall. The weather is just absolutely perfect. We get to come to places like this. I don't even know what this park is. We just drive by and we say, oh, look, there's something. Let's just stop and go in. Or especially a museum. Museums are always the best part for me to go to, especially since we kind of stay on the East Coast. We start in Florida and work our way up north and then start our way back down. So we go through a lot of where the Civil War was. I'm a huge history buff, especially when it comes to the Civil War. So we've been to museums and places where presidents and people have been born and everything, and I really love it. And thank goodness Hernan and Kayla and Joe love museums too. Hernan's a huge history buff. He knows just about as much as I do about American history. And Joe is too. And Kayla, she loves antiques. And so me and her get to go antiquing in a new antique store every week. And it's a lot of fun being able to travel. And it helps, you know, Hernan and Kayla are married and they get to be together with their dogs. And me and Joe are married and we get to be together with our dog. And so if we couldn't be together, I think it would be very difficult and very sad. But it has its ups and downs. You miss family and you miss home, but if I was at home, even in the winter, by the time February comes around, I'm ready to get back on the road. Last month, we performed in Fredericksburg, Virginia, which is about an hour south of D.C., and I had the chance to go up there. We try to go up there every year, and this year, me and Hernan went, and if you've never been to Washington, D.C., you definitely need to go because it's so... You just feel so proud as an American to be there standing at your nation's capital and looking at the splendor of the architect and how everything was built and how it still looks and all the history and the Washington Monument and everything, and it's so beautiful. And I'm glad I've been a few times because this year we went and they were cleaning, or I don't know what they were doing, but they had the Capitol building and it was wrapped and everything. And my favorite monument is the Grant Memorial. To be a homegrown girl from Georgia, for some reason I just absolutely adore Ulysses S. Grant. He was a great person, and probably get hung when I get back to Georgia for saying that. You just feel such a sense of pride, and I love going with Hernan because someone who wasn't born in this country, I don't know if I've ever met a more patriotic person. He loves America as much or more than most of the people that I know. And he has that sense of pride too, you know, seeing his face when he sees, you know, all the buildings or going into the museums and seeing the history. It's really, really nice. And I would love to go sometime when the cherry blossoms are in full bloom and are in the winter time when it snows. But we usually go every summer, and that's our favorite place to visit. I really love what I do. It's so nice to be traveling and to be with my family, and Hernan and Kayla are considered my family. And as long as we're together and as long as we keep to traveling and we have fun, then I'm happy. I could never imagine having another job. And as long as we can be together, I hope we can do this for many years to come.